Okay, so let's do this reaction, the Cannizzaro reaction. Remember, this is a disproportionation reaction. Whenever we see the Cannizzaro reaction, it'll be on aldehydes that have no alpha proton, right? Do you see benzaldehyde? Does this have an alpha proton on it?
No.
No alpha proton, right? Because that would be here, right? And there's no proton there. So if we're going to use a strong base NaOH or KOH, right, on an aldehyde that doesn't have an alpha proton, it'll do this type of redox reaction, okay? And so when I say redox, right, hopefully you can see, right, when I go from benzaldehyde over here to benzoic acid, what's happened here? Has it been oxidized or reduced?
Oxidized.
Oxidized. And then benzyl alcohol?
Reduced.
Reduced. So in other words, we're going to have two benzaldehydes in this mechanism, okay? So has everybody written down what we have here?
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm going to erase it, and then we'll actually draw the mechanism, okay? So I'm just going to write OH minus, because the potassium is a what?
Spectator
ion, right? So we don't even have to worry about it really. What's going to happen, as you might imagine, the hydroxide is going to attack the electrophilic carbonyl carbon. That's going to cause these electrons to go up to the carbonyl oxygen. And this reaction, like we were just saying, really can go back and forth, right? Because the OH can be the leaving group back, right? But what happens in the Cannizzaro reaction, as you might have already figured out, something weird is happening here. Okay, so like we were saying, most of the time probably it's going to go back that way with the leaving group leaving is the OH. But every once in a while, and this is how the Cannizzaro reaction goes forward, right, is it's going to have the leaving group be this hydride here, okay? So in order to have that hydride react with another benzaldehyde, we need to write that benzaldehyde. So let's go ahead and do that. So what did I say? Those electrons are going to come down, and these electrons are going to go with that hydrogen as a hydride and attack that electrophilic carbon there. Okay? So when that happens, those electrons go there. Is everybody okay with what we've done there? So hopefully you can already see one of them is being oxidized, one of them is being reduced. Okay, so that's where we get our forward arrow. So we've made benzoic acid here. Do y'all see that? Benzoic acid. And then here we're going to make the conjugate base of benzyl alcohol. Okay. Remember, potassium hydroxide, that's usually in a water solution. Okay. So what'll happen is two things, right? We still have potassium hydroxide in there. That's an acid. So what's going to happen? We're going to deprotonate that. Okay. And, well, like I said, we have water in there. and it's no problem for us to make more hydroxide. So this will deprotonate that. Okay. So when we do that, I'll just put these two as in the next one. Is that okay, the way I've drawn those arrows like that?
Yes.
So, we have the, essentially, what would be the potassium benzoate here, right? Because if we carried along that spectator ion, that would be the counter ion to that. And we've now made benzyl alcohol. So that was one of our products, right? And remember, the second step was H3O plus, okay? So when we add H3O plus, like that, what's it going to do? Yeah, very good. It's going to protonate our carboxylic acid. Like that. So the two products of the reaction, this particular one, are benzoic acid and benzyl alcohol. Okay? So you need two equivalents of the benzaldehyde to do this. And y'all see, I know we mentioned it before, but that it's a redox reaction, disproportionation reaction. It's got that weird hydride leaving group step, so watch out about that. Okay. Any other questions on this reaction?
No.
Questions? Okay, good.